Bye guys, this is my 5 to 10 minutes broga, bit of stretching, bit of some isometric holds in some of the more extreme angles of where your shoulders and hips can go. So all we're gonna do is warming up into the joints, warming up into the muscles. You can do this in the morning, you can do this at night, you can do this if you've had a long car journey. It literally takes 5 to 10 minutes. You can do a short version or a longer version. You can actually spend half an hour doing it if you'd like to, but we're just gonna do a quick 5 to 10 minute tutorial on how to do all of them. Okay, so the first one you're gonna do is you're gonna do some neck circles. Right, opposite way. So just 5 each side, and then you're just gonna hold your head. Hold it. Done. Alright, then onto your shoulders. Do some small shoulder circles. Here. And back. And then start to go with some bigger shoulder circles. And then back. Okay. Hold it over to one side. And again, hold it over to one side. Okay, so then what we need to do, you're going to reach forward as far as you can, push your shoulders forward as far as you can, and then hands by your back. Reach forward and back. You're going to take your arm. Now, obviously, if you do know me, I've got a bit of a bad shoulder on my left shoulder, so don't so concentrate on this one, concentrate on what my right is doing. You're going to go into external rotation. So you can do this both arms, you can do a single arm at a time. I suggest at the same time do both arms. Do arm as far back as you can. Arm as far down as you can. As you can see, this one's a quite limited range, but I'm sure you guys can do better. That's it for your shoulders. Okay, so for your hips, what we're going to do is just some shallow hip circles. 3, 5, comes the way around. 5, now you're going to take your single leg, lift it up, out as far as you can. 3 one way, 3 the other way. If you feel some clicking and some grinding there, don't worry. Three. Okay, so from there, you do what I say is like a single leg kick, and you're going to go into a hold. So if you need to hold a wall or something to balance you, that's absolutely fine. Wall, from there, kick. Hold. Now if you can't, grab your foot, but you feel a bit unstable, go kick, stretch. If you can't grab your foot, grab a heel of your shin. And if you can't do that, get a towel around and put it back to your side. Definitely don't kick your kid or kick anything else around the kitchen. Okay, so that's that. Then you're going to a walkout. Alright, so chest up. Now, you're going to bend forwards from the hip, over the back, round your back, really bend down forward, arch you over, and then walk out, push it to the floor. Back. Do that 3 to 5 times. Okay, next one you're gonna do, all right, is the final position of that walkout, which is here. You're gonna bring your foot up and then look towards the ceiling. Up it side. And if you can, both feet in. Okay, so again, facing you. Okay, do that 2 to 3 times round. Okay, last one. Okay, means you're going to do a backwards roll. Now, you can try this. It is a really good stretch. if you're not fancy it, you don't have to do it, you can go back. All right, so this one, do get a mat if you've got a mat. If you've not, then you do get carpet burns. Make sure you've got a good excuse for it. So you're gonna roll back. Touch. Okay. Last one. Okay, you're gonna do walk out lunge. Okay, stretch back. Walk out, stretch back. Walk out, stretch back. Good. And stretch back, tense your glutes. So you push your hips forwards. There. There. Try and feel a bit more your hip flexors. Turn out as you lean back. Okay, last thing to do, so if you want to go through that one more time, you can spend 5, 10, 20 minutes doing it, depending on what your mobility is like and where that kind of, where that lies in your priority list. But I would suggest you do this every morning, at least every morning, and if you can, before bed, do it before bed, just make sure you're not getting too out of breath and not exciting yourself when you're doing it. It's just literally a bit of a mobility exercise. The best time really to do it is in the morning and then like an hour in the evening, an hour, 2 hours before bed. Okay, but the last thing you're going to do before you finish is you're going to take some big, big breaths in. Now, what you're going to do with this is it's not just normal deep breaths. You're going to take a deep breath in through your nose, expand your rib cage. I want you to take as much as you can in, and you're going to suck air in through your mouth, force it into your lungs to expand. Okay, so you're gonna go. Last one, you're going to try and hold it as long as you can. All right, if you've got the time to try and hold it for like 1 or 2 minutes, try and hold it and try and beat it each morning. Don't pass out while you're doing it, but it is a really good technique. If you want to learn more about that, it's the Wim Hof technique, but that's just like a bit of a modified version just to do it in the morning. Okay, so let me know how you get on with this. All right, it should take you just like 5 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes. As I say, if you want to make it longer, make it longer. Do as many times a day. I know some people drive quite a lot. It would be quite a good thing to do just while you're driving. Get a bit of a private spot in the car park, just not pissing it down the rain. But if you can get a bit of a private place, just do literally a couple of these exercises, a couple of the more full body ones like the walkout, the T-spine, maybe even the lunge, just to get your blood moving a bit, just to get you moving a bit so you're not getting too cramped up in your car. But yeah, guys, thank you very much. I'll speak to you all soon. Look forward to your check-ins.